Such a tragedy. Last week we lost one of my favorite Christian singers, that is Mandisa. It was quite hard to believe. I was just thinking about Mandisa and I said, oh, it's been a while since I had a new song from Mandisa, because one of her songs was playing on the radio in the car while we were moving, only to check and find that actually she had died. This was Friday when I was talking about her. But life can throw lemons at us sometimes. During her lifetime, Mandisa sang and wrote songs that comforted, touched, and changed people's lives. She was not just a Grammy Award-winning contemporary Christian singer. She witnessed Christ. Since on this channel, I share about Christian news and what is happening that affects Christians, in this video, I'm going to be giving you just a little bit more about Mandisa that you may already know or may not. Her full name was Mandisa Lynn Handley. I don't know if I pronounced that right, Handley. Though she was known as simply Mandisa, she wanted to be known as simply Mandisa.
Hey, what's your name?
Mandisa.
Mandisa what?
Just Mandisa.
Just Mandisa.
The first name is enough to deal with, I think.
All right, so what are you going to sing?
I can do Fallen.
All right,
here we go.
Her journey to fame began with her auditioning for American Idol. After her auditions, Simon Cowell made fun of her weight, but Mandisa later forgave him. Before finishing in the ninth spot in American Idol, that is in the 5th season, which aired in 2005, Mandisa worked for Lifeway as a telephone customer service representative. During that time, she also partnered with the Lifeway Women's Ministry team, performing and leading worship at some events, and later performed at Living Proof Live events. So the team had something to say after her death. Our team at Lifeway is heartbroken to hear of the passing of our friend and former co-worker. Her teammates recall the joy and kindness she brought to work every day. Our heartfelt prayers are with her family, Lifeway CEO Ben Mandrell told Baptist Press. One of Mandisa's songs that got me through some very hard times of my life was Overcomer. Lakeisha Michelle, the late wife of Southern Baptist pastor Buenos, I don't know if I pronounced that name right, Buenos Michelle, inspired Mandisa. Hit Overcomer, the title song of the album that garnered a 2014 Grammy Award for Best Contemporary Christian Music Album.
Overcomer was really, I have it from my friend Keisha, who was battling breast cancer while she was pregnant. And so I really wanted a song to encourage her to stay in the fight, to not give up, and to tell her that she's an overcomer. So when it came out, it meant a lot to her, but then I had some other people that kind of partnered up with me on the music video, and I think their stories are just inspirational to let them know that if we can overcome, then you can too.
Despite all that was done, Lakeisha didn't survive. She passed on, and later the pastor remarried.
Overcomer was inspired by my friend Keisha. She was pregnant with her second child when she was diagnosed with breast cancer, and I prayed hard, like on my face, weeping, crying, and I'll be honest, as I prayed, I really believed that God was going to heal her. Like I'm one of those people that when I feel like God has spoken something to me, I'm not gonna let up, and I hold on to it with everything in me. So when Keisha delivered her son Brennan, and he's beautiful and healthy and will turn four in June, I thought, okay, well, that is the first thing that God has answered about this story, and he's gonna keep doing it. So Keisha had 1 year with Brennan before she went home to be with Jesus, and it shook the foundation underneath me in a way that I was not ready for and really did not expect. And so, yeah, for 3 years, I sat in my house and I didn't want to talk to Jesus. I didn't want to listen to Jesus things. I didn't want to open my Bible. I didn't want to see Jesus people. I was in a deep pit of despair, and I stayed there for about 3 years.
The pastor had something to say about Mandisa's passing. Obviously, we are saddened by her transitioning. Mandisa was just a bright light, a bright witness. She was true to her faith. Even though she dealt with the depression and the issues with Keisha's transition, she just rebounded. And I think that song, Overcomer, and her work just epitomize her life, how she's just been this big overcomer of so many issues, he told Baptist Press. Lakeisha's death from breast cancer in 2014 after the album's success caused Mandisa to spiral into a deep and lengthy depression, which she overcame. Mandisa openly talked about her struggles with depression. She continued to struggle with her mental health, sharing her issues publicly, and in her 2022 book, Out of the Dark, My Journey Through the Shadows to Find God's Joy. She's just been a tremendous overcomer. The scriptures say we sorrow not as those who have no hope. And this is the hope we have, that even in the midst of death there is life. We are saddened, but at the same time we celebrate another young life, but a life well lived. Michelle said of Mandisa. Overcomer won Pop Contemporary Album of the Year at the 2014 Gospel Music Association DAVA Awards. Its lead single was certified as a platinum hit by the Recording Industry Association of America and was the title song for the Kendrick Brothers 2019 movie by the same title. Mandisa was found dead last Thursday at her Nashville home, her publicist announced on social media, and as of now, the cause of her death has not yet been identified. Mandisa loved Jesus, and she used her usually extensive platform to talk about him at every turn. Her kindness was epic, her smile, electric, her voice, massive, but it was no match for the size of her heart. Mandisa struggled, and she was vulnerable enough to share that with us, which helped us talk about our own struggles. Mandisa's struggles are over. She's with the God she sang about now. While we are saddened, Mandisa is home. We are praying for Mandisa's family and friends and ask you to join us. That was from David Pierce, K-Love Chief Media Officer. More condolences keep coming from fans, friends, celebrities, associates, and different people via social media. I've come to learn that a death call is a call we all have to answer someday. It's the only call you can never miss. When your Creator makes it, it has to be answered, and it cannot be dodged. That's why you should always be ready. Do you know where you're going when you die? When you die, why would God let you in heaven? Let's walk while we can. Let's walk towards heaven so that when that day comes, our people can rejoice in the fact that at least they know you're going to heaven. Our condolences go out to the family, friends, and the loved ones of Mandisa.